I got the honors to start the race. We are at Carolina Motorsports Park. It is Saturday, April 22nd of the year 2023, since birth of some dude. Anyhow, this is my third race in 24 hours of Le Mans. Well, it's not really 24 hours. It's like 8 hours Saturday and 7 hours Sunday with the church break. Mainly because of the noise restrictions. You can't race at night because of all the residents around. But there are exceptions for the tracks that are really, really in the middle of nowhere. So here we go, we're getting to the grid. First, I'll get checked out for safety equipment, make sure that the pin is out of the fire extinguisher bottle. I have my hands device on, wristband, I'm really allowed to be on the track, and we will grid up.
Hand out of your bottle.
I got the honors to start the race. We are at Carolina Motorsports Park. It is Saturday, April 22nd of the year 2023, since birth of some dude. Anyhow, this is my third race in 24 hours of Le Mans. Well, it's not really 24 hours. It's like 8 hours Saturday and 7 hours Sunday with the church break. Mainly because of the noise restrictions. You can't race at night because of all the residents around, but there are exceptions for the tracks that are really, really in the middle of nowhere. About to go racing. So, as any self-respecting racer knows, every race is won on the first corner of the first lap. So let's see what happens here. We are at the start-finish straight and we are actively looking for a green flag, and here it is, we go racing. The rule still applies. The Mazda is trying to send it on the inside, but once he sees the Crown Vic, trying to park perpendicular on the track, decides to back off. So we made it safely through the first corner of the first lap. I think that Crown Vic scared the Mazda behind me a little bit, and he decides to chill for a bit. So the track is damp, the tires are cold. I'm trying not to go off-roading on the first couple laps, so I'm taking it easy, kind of warming up the tires, applying the throttle gradually, kind of just easing into the race. To boot, the engine was rebuilt after dropping the valve at Road Atlanta a couple months back, so this engine has pretty much no runtime, so I'm not revving above like 5,000 RPMs for the first, you know, 10-15 minutes, just in general taking it easy. We're about 30 minutes in. I pick up the pace gradually, tires warm, track is dry, car's feeling great, and we're 30 minutes in and we arrive at our friend from lap 1, this little Mazda. He is trying to get around this Lexus in front of him, and I think that's what he's doing, because otherwise I would say he's actively blocking me from passing him, but I don't think that's the case. He just probably eyes front and not even paying attention that I'm behind him. Anyway, I'm not trusting his driving choices and decisions he's making on the track right now, so I'm kind of keeping my distance and trying to find a good opening to pass. Because his power to weight ratio is a little better than mine, so he kind of walks away from me from the straights. So I'm hatching the plan how to get around him. Basically, that's really simple. I need to carry more speed through the corner, exit out of the corner faster than him, start accelerating earlier than him, and I can get him on the brakes on the next corner. Well, at least that's the plan, so let's see how can I execute it. black Lexus that is passing me on the inside is the overall leader of the race. Finally got around those two, and now we're back to regularly scheduled lap times until I overtake this white car way too close to the kink, and I end up way too far to the right and at the wrong angle to take the kink properly, And to boot, I placed the two right tires way too far on the curbing there, which kicks up the rear. Basically, the rear catches air and I land sideways.
It was at this moment that he knew he fucked up.
Car stalls. I tried to start it, but there is a very concerning banging noise underneath. I think it is the driveline, but that makes no sense, right? I'm in neutral, so there is something else banging underneath there. Eventually, I start the car and it drives normal again. So I go to the pits to get it checked out, serve the black flag, and go out again. Nothing interesting happens. Couple of full course cautions, lots of local yellows. Field is thinning out due to mechanical failures also.
Thank you. Have a great day.
And now comes the interesting part. Ryan comes into the pits for a driver change and refuel, and the heavens open up with a thunderstorm of epic proportions. I'm totally soaking wet. I get in the car and realize we did not install the heater blower to defog the windshield. Ooh, so we'll see how this goes. In the beginning, all seems to be okay. However, over the course of two laps, the windshield fogs up so bad, I cannot see the track at all. At one point, I was looking out through the driver's side window at the grass tarmac line to see where the hell I was going and if I was even on the racetrack. At this point, I get on the radio telling the guys that I cannot see anything, I need to come in to clean the windshield. But in this downpour, they went back to the base and they're not at the pit lane. So they need a lap or two to get back to the pit lane, so I have to stay out. So anyway, I continue driving, and at that point the rain stops and visibility starts to improve slowly. So I stay out till the end of the race. There is a river flowing at the kink across the racetrack. The first time I hit it, I slid all the way from the inside to the outside of the track, and good thing I wasn't going full tilt, because I would have ended up in the grass. Well, they were flowing the debris flag, and I was wondering what the hell that was. Now I know. Another notable event was the red flag. This Mazda hit the tire barrier in front of the corner worker stand so hard that they had to stop the race and get the car off the tires and actually bring more tires to actually build the new wall. So we spent some time here. Lemon's races are filled with bad decisions. Just watch that brown car in front of this red Civic. Woohoo! Drifting! And like that, the fun is over for the Saturday's race. Bring the car in, check it out, you know, fix whatever is broken or bent from the off-roading a little bit, get some rest and prepare for Sunday. Unfortunately, we did not get any footage out of the Sunday race because I started the GoPro in some sort of closed-loop capture mode. Or whatever it is, basically, it's like going 55,000 miles an hour. Anyhow, that was all the fun that I have footage of. And we ended up 5th in Class B, if I remember correctly, but don't quote me on that.